AFP and the PNP have come up with a joint letter directive, and we are now conducting checkpoints nationwide in order to implement the total gun ban. And aside from that, we have had more concrete steps towards controlling the proliferation or the trafficking of firearms.
But how do you assure the public now that the military will not be used by unscrupulous politicians to do what they were accused of having done in previous elections?
Well, one thing that is very clear in this election is that the AFP will be nonpartisan, and we will be limited only to the specific roles that were mandated to us by COMELEC. And those are the things that I just mentioned, providing security to specific candidates, and helping the PNP in controlling guns.
All right, I think we have a candidate with a question, presidential candidate, Brother Eddie Villanueva. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. I'm Brother Eddie Villanueva, the standard bearer of Bangon Pilipinas Party. Nilalagay ko yung sarili ko sa ordinaryong karaniwan tao ni Juan de la Cruz. Matapos ko mapakinggan ang relevant questions and comments ni Anthony at ni Jerry, at ang follow-up question and comments ni ang ating ginagalang na ex-COMELEC chairman, Christian Munsod. The more I listen to the inconsistent, I'm sorry, answers of Smartmatic, the more I'm confused that there is no assurance that the spending of $7.2 billion for this project could be justified before the eyes of 90 million Filipinos. Ngayon, ang question ko, ang isang comment ko lang to all concerned, bakit nawala ang people power for the last 9 years sa Pilipinas? Because of poverty, ang sambayan ng Pilipino nagtiis, naging pasyente, hinintay ang May 10, 2010 election upang magbigay ng pag-asa na yung kanilang aspiration for genuine change ay magkaroon ng pangyayari. Pero sa mga narinig ko po, mukhang tama yung mga information dumating sa office ko that this computerized or automated election is bound to fail. Kung ito'y mangyari, ang tanong ko ngayon sa spokesman ng Armed Forces of the Philippines, you were deputized officially by the COMELEC. Which will prevail? The deputation order of the COMELEC or the mandate of the Constitution? If ever there would be a failure of election, which will prevail as far as the leadership of Armed Forces of the Philippines, because AFP is mandated to be the protector of the Filipino people and not just the protector of one vested political interest?
I'm glad you asked that question, Brother Eddie, kasi yan po yung susunod natin na segment, no? If there is, and I'm about to go into a break now, but Colonel Bronner, do you want to answer that very briefly before we give it back to Jerry and Anthony?
Yes, sir. Thank you for the question. Actually, we have been discussing that already at the general headquarters. In case there is a total failure of election, what would be the role of the AFP? It is very clear for the AFP that we will just be involved with security. In case there is chaos around the country, we will just step in. As I mentioned before, we'll step in so far as maintaining peace and order. We will not step in to take control, and that is very clear.
Okay, and we can expound more on that pagbalik natin mula sa break. But Linda?
No, just this still concerns security, but of a different sort. Who is going to provide security for the machines that are going to be deployed? And I ask because dito sa Pilipinas, hindi lang naman, you know, ballot box snatching, physical concerns and security. Is Smartmatic providing for the security?
What we're doing is, once the machines are shipped, notice should be given to the DepEd and the Philippine National Police. First, for the Philippine National Police to provide protection for the machines in the polling place. This is being worked out. notification will also be sent to the political parties and candidates, so they might decide to send watchers to the polling place